Hello, you guys, and welcome back to another Vivian Tries. On this Vivian Tries, I have something really interesting. On this Vivian Tries, we are trying a washing machine. A portable one, a compact one, a little one that I bought from the Wish app. I want to see if these things work. I have a pile of laundry, I have detergent, I have some water. Now let's look at the washing machine. If this thing works, I'm throwing away my front loader. If you guys follow me on Facebook, you know what I'm talking about. You guys ready? I think this thing weighs like 14 pounds. Here we go. Ta-da! Oh, my laundry. Don't mess it up. It's almost dry. I have no idea what to expect from this thing. You guys have actually asked me to review a washing machine in other Wish videos. So when I checked them out, I thought, oh, that's interesting. But then I checked out Amazon, and Amazon has them for about the same price. So I'm like, Wish, don't start raising prices now. We come to you because we like to get dollar shit. I'm not trying to pay a regular price. I think I paid 50 something dollars for this. That's what you can get them on Amazon for. So if this works out, just get it on Amazon. Screw the Wish app. I don't care where you get it, to be honest. If you want one though, just letting me know. Look at it. Look at it. Oh, it's tiny. It's like a bucket of water. It's like that big. It's so cute. Oh, the instructions are inside. You guys can't see it, but they're in there. Why does that tube look dirty? Oh my God, this better not be used. There's a little water hose on the side. In the back, you have your power cord and then a handle, I guess, if you want to move. This is good for like RV, my studio, maybe. Maybe I can do laundry while I'm filming. Apartment. If you're trying to wash like one t-shirt, right? Okay. It's cute. I want to show you guys the inside. Let's get it together. Turn it on. Let me read the instructions first, huh? What do you guys think? Is this thing going to work? This hose here on the side, they're calling the pipe. So what is this for? Because there's already one attached. Why do I need another one? Anybody know? Can you help me? I can't hear you. Employing a new type big wave wheel and a small wave wheel, making clothes cleaner. That's what I'm talking about. That's the technology that front loader I got downstairs needs. Better big wheel technology. Adjust to the expected water level with the handle of water level adjuster. Here in the back, there's low, medium, and high. The clothes, the hit me, Jesus. The clothes put into the tub would decrease the water level. Add more water if necessary. Attention, if there has amount of water in tub, it will spill out of the tub. Wait. All pockets should be empty. Very good. If not, take coins, nails, etc. That's the same as empty pockets, fool. Anything. I'm going to redo these manuals and send them back and be like, listen, it was on me. That was a freebie. I redid your manual. What? Number five. Hairy balls. Number five. Hairy balls. Collar. What? We're washing hairy balls in here. What are we doing? Harry, I don't get it. Now that one, I am totally lost in translation. I don't know what you're trying to say, but that don't sound right in America. Okay? You don't put hairy balls in here. We're gonna test it on medium water level with a couple of these shirts, maybe 10 fit. I don't know. We're about to find out. Very dirty washing, 6 to 10 minutes. Bed sheets, 8 to 10 minutes. That's pretty fast. Okay, guys. So here is your timer. We're gonna set it to... Oh, wait. No. I don't know what that is. Here's your timer. This maybe is like what kind of wash you want, the soft or the standard. And then here's a little water thing that I think goes here. No? We're about to find out. Now I'm going to put this little tube here. Ooh. What is this for? None of the instructions talked about this. It says water intel. What does that mean? The instructions don't tell me what this little knob is for. It's a knob, right? Yeah, I'm gonna put the laundry in first. Don't you think? 1, 3, 8, 9, 10. Put it all in there. Do you think that's too much? Okay, no, I think it's good. You could probably put this on top of your washing machine. Makes no goddamn sense. Who's gonna do that? Why? If you go on vacation, you could probably check this. All right, we have our second bucket here for this. Maybe? No? We're about to find out if this is gonna drain. I wish it was longer. Wait, what is this for? I still haven't figured out what this is for. This is nothing. It's extra. They just gave you extra stuff. Oh my god. No, no. Why is it coming out? Oh no, I think you do this when you have to drain it. You don't touch that. How freaking cute is this damn thing? I love it. It's so cute, right? It's at the medium water level. So far, I'm loving it, you guys. It could be my studio washing machine. Okay, that's good. I just need a little bit of water so I can mix my detergent over here and then pour it in. Don't know why, but I feel like it's gonna wash better. This better work. It was $50 and the Amazon reviews are pretty decent on this thing. So it's probably gonna work. Detergent is in. Now let's turn it on. So the instructions said for really dirty shit, put it for like 10 minutes, it's the max. But no, 15 minutes is the max on here. But I'm gonna do 8 minutes. Like that. And I'm gonna turn it on over here to wash. Ready? 1, 2, 3, go. Wait, it's washing. A washing machine in my studio, neat. I just want to stare at it. 6 more minutes on the timer. I'm just wondering, how do we rinse? Where's the rinse cycle? Right? How do I get the soap off of my laundry? Do I have to put fresh water in and then let it go spin? It didn't tell me on. How? I know it's not a Maytag, but I have questions. Okay, we're done. Now what? I read the entire manual, every single damn line on here, and it's not telling me what to do next. So we gotta get the soap off this clothes. It's washed, but I guess we're gonna drain the water out and then put fresh water in, let it spin around a little bit, and then I think, I don't know what else to do. Okay, put this back. More water out. Oh. The rinse cycle is missing. Rinse and spin cycle. It doesn't have those cycles. So I guess what I'll do is put some fresh water in to get the soap off my damn clothes and then go like this and then hang it. Hell, the instructions didn't tell me. Let me take a peek inside. I want to see what it looks like. It smells like clean laundry. Actually, it's not bad. There's a couple extra steps, but when you're in a compact place, too bad, too sad. You got to just do what you got to do. Fresh, clean water is now in. Do I need more water? It's not spinning as nice as before. Almost done with our rinse cycle. I almost dropped it. Okay, that's enough. Oh shit. I wonder if I should turn it on now and we can have a spin cycle, right? Without any water in it. Let's give it a try. I don't know. Let's see, what is it doing? I'm nosy, I'm gonna see. Is that ruining it? Am I ruining it by doing that? Is it gonna burn out the motor because it doesn't have water? I don't know. This is gonna be your spin cycle right here, right? Because I don't know There's not a spin cycle. It's not Maytag. Not bad, actually, if I can figure out how to use it. So we're back. I have now fresh water, a disgusting floor pad that I use on my Shark floor steamer. For something like this, I would say, I guess, pre-soak it, leave it in the water, just soaking for a little while, just to loosen up some of the nastiness on here. I am gonna put my detergent in my water. Let's put this in. Now our soapy detergent water. Okay, I think that's plenty of water for what I'm washing. One piece. I think we should turn it on for 10 minutes because it is nasty and we need to make sure that shit is washed good. I may have had too many shirts in the other one, but this is looking pretty good, huh? It's actually moving around a lot better. So maybe do 5 t-shirts instead of 10. That's what I had. There's a lot of bubbles. I think I put too much detergent. It was just so nasty. I wanted to make sure it was washed really good, but there's a lot of bubbles. So I obviously put, okay, my panties fell. My panties are back up. So I got too much detergent in here because it's all bubbles. Overkill with the detergent, obviously, because I have this much water and this many bubbles. Okay, so let's start draining some water out of this guy. Bubbles. I needed about a fourth of the detergent I put in there. Most of the bubbles are gone. My pretend rinse cycle somewhat worked. Now let's see how clean this thing really is. Remember, it was in here for 10 minutes. Okay, let's see. I know it doesn't look clean. It is clean. That's just not ever coming off. That's just part of just the nastiness that attaches to these little floor pads. But I mean, it did pretty good. I don't feel any dirt on it. I guess it's not bad for this little bitty machine. I think it's cute. I think it would work perfect for like things that are not too dirty, like light to maybe a medium dirt level, but not heavy duty like this. I mean, this is fine. This is for the floor, but I'm talking about clothes wise. Now, I totally think it's worth the money, especially if you can get it hooked up like in a bathroom. If you could get this attached to water and then this draining automatically for you, have a little setup in your bathroom or in another room that you can get it all set up. Hell, I don't know what rooms you got in your house. I'm just saying that if you had it all set up kind of automated for you, I think it's super cute and it's gonna work. So I'm gonna give this compact washing machine 4 Vivian heads. All right, you guys, so that is it for another Vivian Tries. I hope that you have enjoyed this video. If you have, give it a big fat thumbs up for me. In the comments down below, let me know if you've seen a cool as seen on television product that you think I should try and it might get featured in an upcoming episode. If you're new to the channel, subscribe. I'm putting out 1 to 2 videos every week for your entertainment. Don't forget to share the video with your family and your friends, and I'll see you guys in the next one. Bye. You guys have no idea how many times my laundry line has fallen. During the filming of this video, I've stopped at least 12 times to rehang up my undies.